Hive's arpeggiator and sequencer are presented together in the central hexagon, but we'll explore each in its own video, starting with the arpeggiator. Before we get into that though, let's take in the clock section, which controls the host-synced timing of both. Four bass note values are on offer in the time bass menu: quarter, eighth, 16th and 32nd notes. The selected time base is modified using the multiply knob, which scales the clock speed by anywhere from 50 to 200%, enabling triplet and dotted notes to be used, as well as everything in between. The swing knob dials in shuffle, with 50% equating to a triplet feel and 100% giving a dotted rhythm. And the sync button, when active, enforces strict host synchronization so that the arpeggiator and sequencer always align with the host door's beat grid, not just its periodic timing, regardless of triggering note placement. Onto the arpeggiator itself then, which generates arpeggiated patterns based on held chords. To turn it on, click the on-off button. The basic style in which the input chord is arpeggiated is determined by the direction parameter. Played plays back the notes in the order in which they're received. Up cycles from the lowest note to the highest, while down runs from highest to lowest. Up and down one cycles from the lowest note to the highest, then back down again. While up and down 2 does the same, but repeating the highest and lowest notes before each change in direction. Random plays back a randomly selected note from the held chord. The arpeggio can be ranged over up to 4 octaves, as set in the octaves menu, unsurprisingly. And the handling of octave jumps is established by the order parameter. Serial plays all of the notes in one octave before moving up to the next. Round does the same, but then steps back down through the octaves too. Obviously, this only works with octaves at 3 or 4, since at 2 the result is the same as in serial mode. Leap steps up an octave with each individual note. And repeat plays each note in every octave before moving on to the next note. Restart sets the number of notes that the arpeggiator is allowed to play before restarting. If restart is shorter than the number of notes in the chord, or higher than it but not perfectly divisible by it, the arpeggio will cut off prematurely when it restarts. This will happen on every cycle with shorter restart values, or just the overhanging cycle with longer values. With restart turned off, the arpeggio simply cycles from start to finish before seamlessly beginning again. The clock div parameter slows the arpeggio down relative to the clock settings by a factor of 2, 4, 8 or 16. Why not just slow down the clock instead? Well, because that would also slow down the sequencer. And since the arpeggiator and sequencer interact when both are turned on, you will want to use them together, often at different speeds. We'll look at that in the next video.